Okay, if I could have your attention, please. Our program will begin. But before that, I want to introduce myself. I'm Patrick Haley. I am the chairman of the board of the St. Mary's County Chamber of Commerce. And when I told my wife I was emceeing today, she's actually a school teacher, is and has been for many years, and teaches me many things. She told me to have fun with it. So I got a little joke for you. What is orange and red and full of disappointment? High school pizza. Judging by the food we had last year, I'm thinking that the food this year is going to be a lot better. So welcome to the 2024 State of St. Mary's County Public Schools Luncheon. Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
So first we want to thank you for being here. You know, we appreciate your interest in our public schools as well as your support in our chamber. You should know that this event started back in 2009 because our chamber members wanted to be able to interact with our public school leadership to have better realization of the current status of the system and challenges we as a community face in educating our children. We are in for a real treat today, so we have for superintendent of the schools, Dr. J. Scott Smith with us here. Give him a round of applause. Yeah, thank you. We'll hear from Leonardtown High School Choral Group. Give them a round of applause. And I think, Dr. Smith, you have a short little intro here.
Welcome to all. Let's be enthusiastic. Thank you very much. This is going to be a different State of the School luncheon, much more interactive, a greater opportunity for you, the community, to share with us and our students how you care about St. Mary's County Public Schools. But before we get to that, we do have Bella Voce from Leonardtown High School under the fantastic direction of Miss Kylie Teston, a proud graduate from St. Mary's County Public Schools and Leonardtown High School. And I think that we should probably start with music because that always just, that really does it for me. So we are going to do the national anthem and then a fantastic story and fantastic song. So I believe, although we were just on our feet for the pledge, perhaps we could stand and let's have that fantastic national anthem.
Thank you. back to the times when
worth the price of admission right there. You're also going to get food and we're going to talk, but wow. Thank you. Thank you very much. Again, bella voce.
Real quick, just like to thank the sponsors for today. Before we forget that, most importantly, our Pay It Forward sponsor, AirTech. Thank you very much. Our table sponsors today are Educational Systems Federal Credit Union. Thank you. The College of Southern Maryland. And St. Mary's County, funded through St. Mary's County Department of Economic and Development. Thank you. Also want to take this time to thank the students and the staff of the Forest Career and Technology Center here for hosting the event. We greatly appreciate it. I'd like to thank Commissioner Mike Hewitt for being here. Appreciate you. And let's see. St. Mary's County Board of Education members, how many do we have here today? Yep, so we've... Karen Bailey, Chair, Kathy Allen, Mary Washington, and Dorothy Andrews. So thank you. saw Bonnie Green, the Executive Director of the Patuxent Partnership. And last but not least, St. Mary's County Chamber Board members. Aaron Birch, Cedar Point Federal Credit Union. Amy Dickinson, St. Mary's County Library. Ray Dotson from Cedar Point. Jimmy Hayden Realtor, Remax Homes. Marcia Williams from Williams, McLaren, and Stack, attorney. So this is the Chamber's first year hosting the National Civics Bee, and we appreciate St. Mary's County for partnering with us on that. We look forward to the live Civics Bee, which will be on April 13th at St. Mary's College in Maryland. So look out for that. So at this point, I am going to turn it over to our superintendent, Scott Smith. But before that, we're going to wait to be before your table is called. Ann Lewis will be coming around and letting you know when you can go get your food. So thank you very much.
Thanks, Pat. Well done. You can tell your wife you did a very nice job. So I said this is going to be a little bit different today than previous. By show of hands, how many people have been to a State of the Schools event before? Show of hands. First of all, thank you very much for coming back. Every single year we have more to share. Every single year we move forward. And every single year we have a focus. And this year's focus is a question we all need to ask ourselves. What do you care about most? Or, grammatically correct, about what do you care most? Either way, what do you care about most? Because gathered in this room are students. And if somebody asks me, Scott, what do you care most about? It goes in descending order. Certainly it's my own kids, sure. And my wife, yes, absolutely. So just in case you see Michelle or any one of my children, they came first. I care about them most. But right after that, it's gonna be students. And specifically St. Mary's County Public School students, because I've been working with all of you for 34 years. And I don't think there's any more rewarding and meaningful work than to be done with kids. So kids, we care about kids. Second to that are the people who work with kids, the people who care about kids. So it's fantastic to see all of these community members and our fantastic partners here today, because we're going to talk about what it means to care. So in front of you, you have your annual report. Treasure it. They were really expensive. And a lot of work goes into creating the annual report each year. And this year's annual report is different than previous year's annual reports, because the previous year's annual reports were all about the blueprint. And before the blueprint, the pandemic. I was reflecting this morning on the last time we had a February 29th. And that was 2020. I know it seems like that was about 1,000 years ago, but it was just 4 years ago. And since then, we have been struggling to get our feet back underneath us. And so this year we said, you know what? We're not going to talk about the pandemic. We're not going to talk about the recovery. We're not going to talk about the blueprint. Instead, when we do our annual report, we're going to focus on what matters most. We're going to talk about what we care about. And our student member of the board this year, Ms. Lillian Kibler, and I have been going to every single one of the elementary schools across St. Mary's County, 19 different school visits, and talking to every single fifth grader in the county. And we've been asking them what it means to be a student in St. Mary's County and what it means to care. And then specifically with care, we would break that down and we talk about the specific letters in care. And so, because of the talents of our students and the talents of those who work with our students, they put together a video for today, and I couldn't say it any better than they could. So.
St. Mary's County Public Schools cares about our students. We care about our staff. And we care about our community.
Hello, my name is Lynn Kibler, and I am the student member of the Board of Education for St. Mary's County Public Schools. As an SMCPS student for the past 7 years, I know that SMCPS is incredible. And this year, in order to rejuvenate those intangible aspects of what makes SMCPS so incredible, we created the initiative of SMCPS CARE, Connected, Accountable, Resilient, and Excited to Learn. In this video, we're going to dive into some of those aspects of what makes SMCPS CARE across all of our schools.
SMCPS CARE.
Connected. We are all connected here at the school community through many of the school and extracurricular activities. Sports, clubs, and school spirit activities all promote the feeling of being connected. With many clubs, like the Superintendent's Leadership Group, where all three schools meet and discuss issues in our school and community, the feeling of being connected in one school system is enhanced. Our school system strives to ensure all students feel valued, seen, and heard.
SMCPS CARE.
Accountable. Our school system really wants our community and students involved in their education. We have weekly newsletters from our schools keeping us on track and up to date on school events. We also have many programs in place to monitor grades, such as Schoology and tutoring if you need help. Many schools have reward programs, such as attendance incentives, in place to keep us accountable. We want your student in school every day. Students being accountable for their actions is a lifetime skill to be successful.
SMCPS CARE. Resilient, the power of yet. It ignites a can-do attitude and creates an encouraging environment that helps build confidence that anything is possible. Learning to better balance school and activities helps foster a lifetime skill of determination and perseverance, which lead to a successful future. An example of this is our Apprenticeship Maryland program. Students work in real work environments while maintaining grades and the high school experience. There's so many opportunities for students in St. Mary's County, and we're thriving.
SMCPS CARE.
Excited to learn. Any day you walk through a school in St. Mary's County Public Schools, you will see students excited to learn. St. Mary's County Public Schools offers many pathways in which students can find their passion, from STEM, Academy of Visual and Performing Arts, to the Forest Center. St. Mary's County Public Schools offers opportunities for every student to be excited about learning while being college and career ready.
SMCPS CARE. We hope this helps you better understand how SMCPS is connected, accountable, resilient, and excited to learn. And that is what makes SMCPS so incredible, or as Governor Westmore says, legacy building. And remember, SMCPS cares.
Very nice. You might not know that you have some famous actors in here who took direct part in all of that work. So, connected, accountable, resilient, and excited to learn. These are going to be important. Because as you're eating your lunch, we're going to have tabletop conversations facilitated by our own St. Mary's County Public School students. So if you are a St. Mary's County Public School student, whether you be a SLAC student or a SkillsUSA student or a student who's affiliated with the Tech Center program, raise your hand. First and foremost, can we thank them? Thank you very much for being with us today. They're going to kind of help facilitate that conversation and to answer any questions that you might have about the annual report that's before you. The annual report has a whole bunch of stuff in there. It's not only about connected, accountable, resilient, excited to learn, but you can also find fast facts about class size, about supporting services, about all of the different elements that make up St. Mary's County Public Schools and our very complex and meaningful work. And in fact, you can even find information about our current budget. Now, we're not going to talk about the 2025 budget. We'll leave that for other meetings, but understand that we are the largest investment each one of you makes in St. Mary's County as you are paying your income and property tax. It goes to the school. And so what we want to do for you today is to demonstrate the value of that investment by hearing directly from the children your tax dollars serve. So, we're going to be released, and we're going to go have some fantastic lunch. Chef Poe and the fantastic culinary arts students have put together an incredible lunch for you. As you go and you get your food and you come back, engage in a conversation. We have resources to facilitate that conversation. But as we draw to the end of our lunch, we're going to call on each one of your tables by number. So for example, table seven. Oh, Lucas, table seven. We're gonna talk about what your conversations at your table have been about St. Mary's County Public Schools, about how we're connected to one another, about how we're accountable to one another, about how we need to practice being resilient, and most importantly, how we are all excited to learn every single day. So, when we come back, we're not gonna gather cards and write stuff on, we're going to call on your table. And somebody at your table is going to share the conversations that you had. And just so you know, I've told all of the students that their job is to identify the adult who is going to be sharing. So they have a great deal of power. Treat them with the respect they deserve. And so with that, I believe we're going to start releasing tables. Any questions? Everybody know? Everybody have a little bit of anxiety? Are you afraid to talk in front of a group? Good times. All right, great. Thank you. I'm sorry, Miss Dahlstrom. They have an extra microphone. So let's see. Are you going to be my helper? You going to be the helper? Oh, nice. Okay. Well, we're not there yet. We want everybody to have a high level of anxiety right now. So, what's important to our students? It's important to our students, we've been hearing from them throughout the year, that they know that adults in their life care about them. All of the students from elementary, middle to high, we talk about like what makes the biggest difference in the classroom or in your endeavors. It's that they know that you care about them. Incredibly important. So we came up with at the beginning of the year, and Lillian isn't here, and that's a shame. She is a student member of the board. She is amazing. She can put more words into a minute than anybody I have ever met. We visited all of the schools and went through all of this, but she really is one of the driving forces behind CARE, Connected, Accountable, Resilient, Excited to Learn, especially Excited to Learn. Dr. Mara and I were like, engagement. And she's like, what? Excited to learn. So, for a discussion today, we talked a little bit about the investment that we make in public education, not an expense. Don't call it an expense. An expense, you pay for something and then it's done. An education is an investment that pays off forever. Great work of students and staff. We care, talk to our students. You've already gone through and taken a look at all of this. So let's go through our letters, shall we? Connected. Now you watched a video about connected. You have a brochure that talks about what it means to be connected. Hopefully you talk to a student at your table about connected. But now with the help of Amina, we are going to pull, what? Amina, sorry, I keep on calling. Sorry, I knew somebody named Amina. Amina, she's going to draw, and she's going to hand the stick to me, and it is table 15. Where's table 15? Oh, nice. Table 15. So we know that, and this is from our brochure, right? We have pathways, advisories, activities, and programs, and things like that. We've already talked about that. But what we want to hear is from you at your table as community, what does that mean? What is, talk to us a little about table, talk to us about connections. Who's going to do the talking over there, first of all?
I guess I will.
You were going to, okay, all right. That's fantastic that you, how about if you start and then you can hand it off to somebody? That might be great.
So I think connections are a big thing within our school system and with our community. I think the school system needs to be connected to the outside community in order for it to function. I mean, without everybody around in the community helping out the school system, I don't think the school system would be able to function. And within the school system, teachers, the administrators, the students all have to be connected. I mean, you look at a football game where everybody's out there for the same thing, having fun. There's parents, there's students, there's the administrators there, and they're all connected through something like that.
Yeah, and that's a fantastic example, because oftentimes you go to a football game and it's wonderful, but there are so many hands in making that event happen. Everything from our incredible boosters to all of our support staff to all of our relationships with the school resource officers, all of that together. That's fantastic. What a great example. Does anybody else at table 15 want to share a little bit about connection? Do any of the adults at that table? Miss Green, yes. Thank you.
Well, rather than wait for you to call on us by name.
That comes later.
Since the Patuxent Partnership has been working with St. Mary's County Public Schools for a very long time, and so many of the sponsors and the other people here in the room also are doing so, what's amazing is to see the constant growth in the connections. You know, the Tech Jobs Rule Program is a great opportunity, and Thomas has shared some of his work, but some of the sponsors in here are participating. Some of the other students are interested in it. All of those are pipelines and connections to career opportunities here in St. Mary's County, where Thomas kept saying, we were talking about how people come here and say there's nothing to do, but everyone who lives here knows that you have to make hard choices about what you want to do. So seeing the success of this program and talking to these students and being a part of it in a small way is amazing.
Now, that's quite a start. Thank you so much. That is awesome. Amina, you did a great job with that one. So, connected. Do we all, when we say connected, we all pretty much know what that means, right? And that is probably one of the greatest functions of a public school system, is that we absolutely, positively cannot do our work alone. We have to be connected to each other, to our parents, and to the larger community we serve. And we have a room full of incredibly dedicated, connected partners. And just thank you very much for being here. So let's move on to accountable. Ooh. This one was a lot of fun, by the way. If you want to really talk about what it means to be accountable, right, talk to a fifth grader. Fifth graders know. So let's see how you do. Amina. Table number 10. Where is table 10? Oh, there's table 10. Table 10, who's going to do some talking?
Yay, public speaking.
Yay.
Okay. Accountable. So I have had the pleasure and the opportunity of talking to the two students here, and accountable, you know, is showing up, right? They are showing up. I'll do a little backstory. So, you know, they sat at our table. They had never met before, and through the conversations of what they're working on, they're both going into mechanical engineering, and, you know, this lunch gave them the opportunity to meet and to connect together and to learn that they are, you know, working towards the same goal. They are also both planning on attending the same college in the fall. And so I know for me, like, accountability is showing up, doing what I need to do, you know, even on the days that it's hard, even on the days that it's great, you know. Let me see what you have up here. Attendance, yeah, so showing up.
Yes, we have. So this is for students, right? For us, for St. Mary's County.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Yep, so certifications and credentials, graduation requirements, all of that, you know, staff. Yeah, accountability is showing up, you know, and these two students exhibit that. They show up and they do what they need to do to get to where they want to be. They're dedicated and they're driven and extremely intelligent. And you spoke about accountability in fifth graders. I have a fifth grader who, my children go to school over in Calvert, but I'm really grateful for the opportunity to be here and to learn. And this is the first time I've been to something like this. I have a fifth grader who is safety patrol, she's in drama, and she is doing chorus at her school. And so one day, her sisters, I have three girls, her sisters were gonna stay home from school that day, take a mental health day, right? And Peyton, my fifth grader, she was like, oh, I really wanna stay home, but we have this safety patrol meeting that was put off. We were supposed to have it yesterday, it was canceled, postponed for today, and I don't wanna miss that. And I was so proud as a mom that she took the accountability to get up and go to school that day, even though her sisters were not, you know, so.
That is that is fantastic. That's awesome. You're as good as a fifth grader. That is an incredible, important part, how we are all accountable. Thank you very much for sharing that. That's awesome. So, resilient. A big R, we'll call it. Because, again, if we go back to April 29th, 2020, I had a definition of resilient. Wrong. It's something much, much more. So you talked about it at your table. Let's talk about being resilient. Mina? Ooh, table four. One, two, three, four. Oh. So, resilient, what does that mean? What does that mean to table number four?
So we unfortunately did not have a student at our table.
Right. I mean,
it was still
right,
great,
so you have to be resilient in the absence of
did.
A subject matter expert. You have to draw upon your
correct.
Own personal knowledge to talk about being resilient.
Correct. So we spent a lot of time talking about kind of all of our roles with businesses and economic development and kind of how important the school system and the students are to the future of the workforce, the future of the county, the future of what we're all doing here. So from the, we touched on a lot of different things, but with the resiliency standpoint, I think it's important because some of these, the initiatives we talked about, the great things that are happening in the school system, Check Jobs Rule, doing tours of our businesses to expose them to all the incredible career opportunities that many don't know even exist here, is a really long game process of ensuring that it's not gonna happen overnight, but we need to be resilient in the fact that we're all going to the same mission of exposing and sharing our students with what careers are here, to keep them here, want them, allow them to want to stay while also giving them good jobs, so.
Fantastic answer, very well done. And I think that's a key piece of all of the tech job rules, the AMP program, all of the political, all of the program advisory committees that work with the tech center, is you need to show people what the future could hold. Give them something to inspire them and aspire to, because oftentimes resiliency flags when you don't see what's next. You are definitely helping our children see what is next, and we thank you for that. Well done. All right. The last, and we're going to call on several tables to talk about Excited to Learn, because although Ms. Kibler isn't here, this was her favorite part of talking to all of the students and all of the fifth graders and all of the other people. What does it mean to be excited to learn? And it was funny, the fifth grade students, it took a little while to get started, but then we finally said, so why did you come to school today? What about today is exciting? And it could be something as simple as there's safety patrol, there's something going on. What makes somebody excited to learn? Because that is key. Without excitement, it's not a very exciting lunch. If we were just here and I was going to give you a PowerPoint presentation, I wasn't going to call on you individually, you didn't have anxiety,
that wouldn't be anywhere near as much fun for me. This is fun for me. I'm excited to learn more from all of you. So, with that, lucky number 13. Lucky number 13. Virginia. What do we got for excited to learn?
I knew it was going to be me. I knew it.
Yeah. Well, you have an incredible enthusiasm for what you do.
I do. Yes. I do. You know, it was amazing talking to Virginia today. I mean, I have hope for the future. I have hope for the future. This is all I'm saying. But to talk to somebody who really, after the pandemic, had wanted to do virtual learning, but her parents said, yeah, you need to go in there with people and go see people. The opportunities that the school system made for clubs and for things to find connectivity with people that they like that didn't exist before. There's always been clubs, but you guys created new ones, which I hadn't realized. For going and finding the things with, she's at the Academy of Visual and Visual Arts and Performing Arts. She's got this side, but then she's also going to be a lawyer. So she's finding things in her studies that are wanting to make her go further, to make her do more, but still find the avocation as well as vocation, which I think is incredibly important. And it's exciting when that combination comes together with these students. And it was wonderful to see it with her. And I'm going to see her on something someday. I know I am. But I'm just excited that these opportunities are existing. And we said we weren't talking pandemic,
right?
But post-pandemic, this is the time where that change should be happening. And there are still things that need to happen. I know there are opportunities you'd like to be able to provide, which you still can't because it's a funding thing. And I get that. And the students will be excited if you can find those opportunities. But they're coming. And I'm excited to see what these kids are doing and experiencing and finding that excitement because the school system is providing it.
Oh, yeah.
That's amazing.
And really, Ms. Barber, thank you very much. And as we've seen recently, theatrics and legal, I mean, they're together. It's quite the show. It's been a lot of fun to watch. Certainly, we're all paying attention. Let's see, something else, somebody else. Let's call on other people, what it means to be excited to learn. All right, let's see. Ooh.
Mark over here.
Oh, Mark's always excited to learn. All right. Yes, let's get a microphone over here for Mark. All right, so pull the popsicle stick for five out.
She's got a point. I was okay. Like, all the other tables were getting cold, and I'm like, I need number five to be cold, like, right now.
As a former teacher, I would love to have you in my class, Mark. I would love to have you in my class.
Go back to teaching then.
There's a very
Nobody's
good
Nobody's stopping you.
Depending on how things go, I've kept my certification in place. I may well be there.
So for excited to learn, after the pandemic kind of screwed up my life a little bit.
Yeah, right.
Being stuck on virtual for months was the worst thing, especially with my siblings. Going back to school and being able to communicate with everybody that I was snapping, calling, FaceTiming, really gave me an opportunity to develop that connection that I didn't get in middle school. So being back at school really gave the fundamentals of being an actual person. And I was able to see teachers that I wasn't able to see on virtual and interact with how their personalities are. And personally, myself, I like to interact with the teachers in person because sometimes when you have to join a meeting and they don't want to, it does not seem fun.
Yeah. Well, again, we in the personal interaction with one, there's so many things going on and it's sharing physical space with people. That's mm-hmm. essential. That's essential. Ms. Williams also has things. Yes.
Yes.
Very well done. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Excited.
Yeah.
To learn.
And in our conversation, can I just stand? In our conversation with Mark, he told us it showed that he was excited to learn. Next year he will be the chief commander of the Air Force.
ROTC. Yes, he will. Yep.
Ooh, yeah. cared at school. He was excited to meet the incoming class of 2027.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. Yeah. And, he said he was excited to tell them, this is a great opportunity. High school is a great opportunity. It's a great time to explore different things in different areas and also be yourself, and encouraging them to be yourself. And then speaking with other students, Gabby, Lucas, and I, sorry, I didn't get their names right there, but they're excited to learn. She was telling me that coming to the tech center was the best part of her day, and she's excited to be in media. So it's great, it's a great opportunity, and St. Mary's County Public Schools is creating a great opportunity for our students to learn and get excited, not only from the different clubs, but from the different programs, STEM, ROTC, the Tech Center. Lucas has found his path, so it is a great opportunity. Gabby, congratulations on the academic brain brawl for ROTC at Great Mills High School. So the future is bright with our students.
Thank you so much. That's awesome. Excited to learn, excited to lead. That is awesome. So when you walk away, St. Mary's County Public Schools, students and staff care. And when we talk about care, we talk about how we're connected, accountable, resilient, and excited to learn. Now, you want to talk about the blueprint? I don't. Want to talk about the blueprint and money? I don't. Want to talk about the blueprint and the things that are in it and things that are not in it? I don't. But to be transparent and to give everybody an opportunity, we have been holding town halls. They are fantastic. They have been well attended in person. They can also be streamed live during the time if you want to play a drinking game or something at home. And or they're archived on YouTube, so afterwards you can go back and take a look at the conversations that were had. They've been great. We have talked about early childhood. We've talked about resources for student success. We've talked about college and career readiness. And on March 12th, very, very soon, we're going to be talking about pillar two, which is teachers and leaders. And of all the parts of the blueprint and all the parts that are aspirational, this is the one that's closest to my heart, because this is about teachers. This is about people who see for themselves a goal of teaching other people. And no one is in this room without the help of a teacher. So we're not going to talk about it today, but we are going to talk about it on Tuesday, March 12th. I encourage you, please, to come out and join us. We'll have great information to share. We have our lovely and wonderful association members in the far corner. We are going to ratify, hopefully tomorrow, a four-year agreement that upholds all of the principles of the blueprint. And I believe people from the outside of St. Mary's County, because there are people outside of St. Mary's County, I guess over in Calvert and things like that, but you come here and that's lovely that you're here. When they see our work, when they see the way we care about each other, we are going to inspire others. And that is the greatest gift you can give. So with that, I end with the same thing. About what do you care most? And of course, you're going to have to say, if you're married, please say your spouse. And then if you have children, please say your children. But after your spouse and your children, and you can decide which one comes first, because that depends on how long you've been married. What matters most is the future. And the future of St. Mary's County Public Schools is so strong. And it's so strong because of our children. And it's so strong because of the people who work with our children. And it's so strong because of everybody else in this room who comes together to support us in this work. So just thank you very much for your lunch. I hope you had a great time. Thank you very much for joining us. I'm going to hand it back over to Pat, and Pat's going to bring it all home. Thank you.
Okay, just want to thank Superintendent Smith again and his entire team. So we appreciate it. Give him a round of applause. One more time to our table sponsors, St. Mary's County and the Department of Economic Development. Thank you very much. College of Southern Maryland and Educational Systems Federal Credit Union. So we really appreciate it. I know I'm very full because lunch was delicious. I'm sure you would all agree. So thank you for the students and the entire culinary team. It was awesome. Really, really good stuff. So thank you. Last thing I'll say, I'll just end with, we talked a lot about connection. It's good to see, you know, so many people from so many different places, businesses, government, the entire team, you know, coming together. And that's what the chamber's all about. It's really where business and community meets. So we appreciate you coming today, and enjoy the rest of the day. Thank you. Good job.
Well done, thank you.